So what I've got here is an old pill bottle. I've got all the incriminating information scraped off the label. And you can see it's I'm using it as a queen cage. I drilled like really small holes in it, in the all around the whole the bottle, but they're too small. And so I drilled 1/4 inch holes all around it. And I know the bees can't get through 1/4 inch, but so that's good enough. So they're trapped inside, but their pheromones, the queen's pheromones, should still be able to escape, and she should still be pretty protected well within this pill bottle. And so that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use it as a queen cage to introduce her to a hive that is currently queenless, and we'll see what happens. So this is like, the poor man's version of a queen cage. You can order queen, well, like everything else in beekeeping that you order online or at a store, especially in Newfoundland, it costs a fortune, right? It's none of this stuff is cheap, and so, but everyone can get a pill bottle, right? Just go buy a bottle of aspirin or something, or just, an old prescription bottle, whatever. So 1/4 inch, not 1/4 inch, 1/8 inch holes drilled all around. Put her in there with a couple of attendants, and you're good to go, I hope. So I'm gonna put it in this hive over here, and we're gonna see how it works out. Sometimes when a colony gets queenless, they get really defensive and aggressive. And these guys are definitely doing that. Man, these bees are really trying to sting me. Or at least they're not happy. And anyway, I've got my little queen cage right down there. And hopefully they'll notice that the queen is in there, and they'll keep her warm for the next couple days. Right now they're not really noticing her, but I think they will. The word will get around, I hope. Maybe, you know what? I think I'll actually make that, put that further down on the frame. Okay, so there she is down there. Hopefully they'll, where is it? Where is she? Right down there. There you go. So hopefully they'll get a whiff of her pheromones. She's not in a full open cage. Maybe I should have drilled more holes in it so they could really get a good whiff of her pheromones. But anyway, hopefully they'll get a whiff anyway, and it'll work. We'll see. But these bees are not happy at all. So it's only been a couple of days since I tried to introduce this mated queen, this old mated queen, to this hive, the small ex-mating nuc. And I've got it in my pill bottle, and let's see what we get. Let's see if they're ready to accept her. I think they are, so I'm just gonna go for it. I'm gonna manually release the queen. So they seem to be acting like they like this queen. Well, they're not trying to sting her. They're not trying to sting me. I think they're happy with her. I'm gonna roll the dice and see what happens. So I think if these bees were trying to kill their queen, or the queen that's in there, they would, they'd be trying to sting her. They'd be trying to sting her through those holes. And see, right now, they're really, where am I? There I am. They're really easy to just move off. See, they're not trying to sting me. They'd be really, they're really, they're not aggressive at all. So I think they're ready to, for the queen. Okay. So I've got the top loosened, and I'm going to release the queen. Let's see what happens. Come on, baby. There she is. There she goes. She's right there. And that's it. She's gone. There she goes. Right there. And that's it. She's gone. You can see they're all sort of, they can smell the queen's pheromones inside that thing. And they're like, oh, where is she? Where'd she go? But she's already down the, between the frames. Down there somewhere. So I think they're happy. I would call this a successful installation of a mated queen.